We are going to start off here in a seated position today in our Sukhasana, easy sitting. Whereas ideally in Sukhasana, you are in a cross-legged position where you have a very big triangle of space between the legs. So if you were to look down, you would see your mat through the legs. So a lot of times I'll see people sitting with their feet really bunched up into their body. And to be honest, if my feet are cold, I'll do that myself sometimes because it keeps them warm. But you don't really get a very good base when you have your feet drawn really, really close into you. You're not able to move very well and keep yourself real steady. So we bring those feet and those shins out a little bit. We create a very broad space so that when we do move around in the seated position, you have a really good stable base to be there. All right. Sitting tall, let's go ahead and reach back and remove your flesh, or just move your flesh from out from underneath your sit bones. And put your behind behind you, and you're able to feel those two bones at the bottom of the pelvis, your sit bones, and you can ground them into the floor a little bit more, shift your weight into those two bones, then draw the spine long, hands wherever is comfortable to you, and close the eyes if you'd like. And we're just shifting our attention to ourselves, to our breath. Shifting our attention away from all that outside information, media, news, noise, and returning to ourselves. How all of our senses are perceiving this moment right now. Resetting and restoring. Knowing that anytime your mind tries to go back to that outside noise, that outside information, rein the mind back your senses to this moment, this reality that is just in front of you and inside you. Staying connected with the flow and the sound of your own breath. With the movement and the sensations of your own body. As we inhale, reach the arms out and up. Touch the palms, lift your face. And exhale, take a forward fold any amount. Bring sensation into your low back, into your hips, your thighs. And if you explore movement around, you might create sensation to your arms, side body, shoulders, neck. And walk it back in. So for here, remember which leg you have in front. Yeah, so we're gonna do the opposite a little bit later, but it's gonna be some time before we get there. Take your right leg, extend it out to the side. Bring your left foot in just a little bit more. And really flex out the right foot. Spread your toes. Try to straighten the leg and activate the leg. I mean, you're kind of pressing the leg into the ground and your thigh contracts, right? You want this leg to be strong. Inhale, reach the arms up to the sky. Forward fold, exhale, hands down, walk it up any amount to stretch to your right inner thigh. be mindful that the leg, the foot, doesn't roll forward, right? Keep your toes facing up and spread. Keep the leg pressing. Then start to walk your arms, your torso over to the left, kind of folding into this bent leg. If you reach out through the right arm a little bit more, you'll get a little more extension down that right side of your body. Feel the compression in the left side of your abdomen and in that left hip, left thigh. Can you get a little heavier into the leg? Start to sweep over to the leg, the right leg, as much as you can. Maybe reaching further out the left arm and getting that left body extension. Keep your leg pressing into the floor. Your right leg is really going to want to just sort of get a little bit lazy and relax here, but keep it active. Pull the toes back. Breathing big through your belly. Tongue at the bottom of your mouth. We're going to walk it all the way back up to center. Sitting tall. Inhale, reach the arms up to sky. Side bend over to the right. Exhale, right hand comes down. We're going to reach over. Hold this first one. Your bottom hand can be on the leg, front of the leg, or behind the leg. It's wherever feels natural for you. You might start to drop that bottom elbow a little bit more, the bottom shoulder. Gazing up as much as you can. Roll your belly, open toward the ceiling, the heart, the armpit. Inhale, come up to center, arms up. Good. Two more times. Exhale, over to the right, just one breath this time. Go a little bit deeper. One more time. Inhale, center, lift. Exhale, over to the right. Inhale, high center, to the heart. Exhale, bring it in. Let it relax, and draw this right leg in. Legs out in front, and give them a little shake out. Roll ankles, wiggle toes, up, down, side to side. We're gonna take our cross-legged Sukhasana, the other leg in front than you had when you started. Yeah, do you remember which one it was? Hopefully, you might reach back and remove your flesh out one more time so you ground into the sit bones. Inhale, just sit tall, working through the neck. Exhale, drop your chin to your chest and begin to roll the neck in any direction that feels good. You can just keep it down the chest if that is what you need today. Notice the tension you're carrying around the neck, upper back, and shoulders. Let that tension go. No judgment of our own tightness, our own bodies. We're all doing the best we can. Keep exploring. If you find that one special spot, linger there. Let it stop. Gently return your head up to center. between your hands. We're going to bring your fingers to the base of your skull. Lift your chin, looking up to the sky, or you can even close your eyes if you want to, and just wiggle your fingers into the base of your skull. Create circles, create a massage. You can explore kind of around that base skull area, maybe going a little higher up the head, maybe a little bit lower, a little more out to the sides or centered. Sometimes, those of you that have some nails, sometimes that pressure of the nails is almost like a little acupressure, and you can enjoy that sensation as well. If it doesn't feel good, don't do it. From here, you're taking your hands and tuck them, like little sea hands, or called Lego hands. Tuck it around your neck. Use the fingers and pull your neck flush forward and down. And do it again. Forward and down. Just repeating. This can even go into the top of your shoulders. Pull the flush. Forward and down.
I have chosen to be bound by these towers, saved. It is safe. I forgot the shape of
you can close your eyes. So you can kind of take one hand at a time if you want. You can cross over if you want. Let yourself explore. I think a lot of us have been lacking human touch and interaction. It's nice to have this skin-to-skin touch, even if it's with yourself. Working out all that tension.
Sitting before the moon.
And let it release. Bring your hands together to your heart space. Interlace your fingers. Knuckles to the top of your head. Pull against the fingers to create the resistance. And start your exploring movements here. Side to side. Circling the ribs and the arms. Arms go straight if you prefer. Breathe. If it feels good, you are on the right path. You've discovered a little discomfort, a tight spot, you're in the right path. If you have sharp, stabby pain, you can't breathe. Wrong path. Back off a little bit. Maybe not take so much. Take something a little bit different. From here, palms up to the sky, big inhale, we're going to flip so that the palms are facing down and touch your palms to the top of your head, top of the head. From there, shoulders down. And you're actually going to push a little bit, push the hands into the head just a little. You're not trying to create a huge amount of force, but just enough where you feel the activation of hands, neck, arm, shoulders, right? There you are. I'm going to turn sideways. You can see the movement of the shoulders, hopefully a little bit better. As you inhale, roll the shoulders up, back, and down. As you exhale, back, up, forward. Inhale, up, back, down. Rolling them back. Exhale, roll them forward. Don't worry about the elbows. They just kind of move naturally. As you move, keep that little bit of pressure between the head and the hands. Notice, keep going. Notice if you're tending to start to slouch now, right? Really draw the spine up. And for those of you who do have that slouching kind of habit, almost think of it as if you're going to arch. You're not actually going to arch, but thinking about arching helps you to kind of get out of that collapse a little bit better. For those of you that do arch, you gotta go the opposite. You gotta kind of pull in a little bit. You're trying to create that neutral spine.
You come and go.
We're working out that tension in the upper back and shoulders. We're creating a little bit of strength here in the neck with that pressure.
Steps in.
Are you still moving this with your breath? Your next inhale, arms just extend up and open. Take your time. And exhale, forward fold, reach it out. Take what you need here, breathe.
Reckless season, take the will to grow. And once you show the shapes you pull,
walk it up.
Count the way.
Left leg out to the side.
I see you.
Spread your toes. Flex your foot. Activate the leg. Whole time. It's going to really want to go lazy on you. You got to keep that awareness, that self-connection, and stay aware of what the leg is trying to do, right? Body and mind connection. That's what we're all trying to do with our yoga. Bring them together. From here, inhale, reach up to sky. Exhale, bring it forward and down any amount. Make sure the leg does not roll forward. Inner thigh, stretch, breathe.
Facing all the ground. And once you show the shapes you pull,
start to walk to the right.
Count the way I see you. Come and go.
As low as you can, walk it over to the left.
We are young.
Any amount.
And fit to fight.
Do what you can.
A frozen sun. Love, my love, and I.
In today's society, it's often discussed or talked about how short our attention spans are. How long are you able to stay with your leg, your body, your breath, before you realize that you've wandered off and lost the awareness and the control? And not judgment, just aware. Notice. Every time you pull your attention back and really focus, we are slowly, slowly improving that attention, the ability to stay connected and stay present.
If you ever need someone,
walk it all the way up to the sky. Arms lift. Side bend over to the leg. And the first time you hold, kind of figure out your alignment, where you want your hand to be, elbow or shoulder down. Top arm can be high, any amount over the head. If your shoulder is achy, bend your elbow. Look up to the sky as much as you're able to. Get your chin out of your throat. Now you kind of found where you want your body to be today, where it can go. Here we go. Inhale to the sky. And a little deeper. Exhale to the left. Inhale, lift. Exhale, reach. Inhale, center. Heart. Exhale. Let it relax. Bring that left leg in and extend. Shake it out. Good. From here, we're going to come up onto our knees, all the way up onto the knees. You can always use a blanket or a towel to cushion under the knees if you need it. And we're going to try our best to keep our knees about in line with our hips, because what's going to happen is a lot of times the knees will start to slide outward like this, and then you're throwing your hips joints out of alignment and knees out, and it's not going to feel good over time. So just kind of stay aware of the legs. Yeah, I'm going to turn sideways. Hands onto your hips. Kind of a little cat-cow inspiration here. So as you inhale, you're going to actually tilt your tailbone out a little bit behind you, almost like you're going to sit down, but you're not going to. Open up the heart, look up. Exhale, now tuck. Lean back a little bit again, but try to bring your grounding into your spine. Tuck that tailbone big, tailbone up toward this head. Inhale, open. Exhale, tuck. We're adding leg strength, and when you do that inhale back, you can pulse it a little bit. You're going to feel that butt squeeze squat motion. Exhale, tuck. Inhale, open. Exhale, tuck. One more time. Inhale, open. And squeeze. All fours. One foot out, then the other. Ooh, stretch it out. When you're ready, find your traditional cat-cow. Arms under shoulders. Inhales. Open belly and heart. Look up to the sky. Exhale, rounding head between the arms. We can add movement. It feels good. And even keep going. Even here in cat cows, notice if your knees are trying to splay, right? They're trying to go wider than your hips. Keep them just under the hips, in line with the hips. Neutral spine. Now bring the knees touching up together. Your right leg, and inhale to extend it up and up and behind you. You can always do a little wrist lift here or come onto your fist if you need a little extra space in the pose or if the wrists are giving you issues. Inhale, extend a little higher, open. Your exhale, step the foot between the hands, bent knee. The both knees are bent about 90 degrees now. You can still cushion under the back knee if you need it. And we're bringing the arms up to the sky. Inhale, lift. You can exhale, heart, or hips. Right. That same kind of tuck that we did in the cat, that rounding, yeah, your hips. We're going to do, let's just do the cow first. So inhale, tailbone back cow. Exhale, tailbone tuck. This one, just focus on the hips. Don't worry about your upper body. One more time. Inhale, tailbone back. Exhale, tailbone tuck. Hold that. The more you're pressing your tailbone, your hips forward, you're getting a stretch in that bottom leg. This leg down here. In the top of your left thigh. If you want more, lean it back. Leaning back, but still trying to push your hip forward. Beautiful quad stretch right there. Bring it back. Inhale. Let the arms reach up. Just a big stretch. Open, release. Actually, just go to half split. Bring it back down. Crawl your toes forward. Straighten the front leg as much as you can. This is where you can put your hands on yoga blocks or books, shoe boxes if you want to. If you need a little bit more space, roll the ankle around, wiggle your hips.
those dreams the way our paths have crossed that we would.
You can stay with your torso at center. You can walk your torso over to the right, over to the left. What feels good? What does your body need? Where are all those tight spots today?
I'd love to spend the night, but I can't pay the price. No.
Take your time. When you're ready to move on, you shift your weight forward, come into that low lunge. Yes. From here, take this right hand, bring it inside of your foot. Now we're going to lizard. Walk your foot to the inside edge of your mat and start to explore here. You can stay high on your hands. You can go down on one or two elbows. You might roll into the side of your left hip. Forward, backward. I want to give you a crooked monkey option here as well. So you already opened up that quad and hip a little bit when you were up on the knee. So maybe you have a little bit of space now to bend the knee, reach the right hand back, and take that stretch further. Crooked monkey. Maybe not, and that's okay. Breathe. If you're holding on to that back foot, let it go. Coming up onto your hands. Return the right arm to the outside of your leg. We're going to do kind of a different one-legged pigeon today, so really kind of pay attention for a moment. You're going to be lifting those hips a little bit. Walk your foot over to the other edge of your mat, right? Not into your body, directly over to the other edge of the mat. Keep your hips up high and bring the right knee down. So if you're pretty tight, your hips might be really high. You might almost be like an all fours. That's okay. We're gonna keep our front shin parallel to the front of the mat for now, So if you're very tight, you might look like you're in all fours. Start to really bring that back leg out as much as you can. Settling into the hips. Now this variation is a bit more intense, but it might reveal to you how much you tend to kind of cheat your pose. I'm kind of rocking side to side just because it feels good. If you're able to, some of you I know can just settle into the full pose here. But our goal is to not change the front leg. Not yet. Really? Let go of the ego. Let go of the expectation. Stay with this alignment. Connect to the tight spots. Lock the places. Now you can adjust and do the variations. Meaning, you can bring your front foot more into your body, right? Angled in, and that allows you to have that space and time. You can lean off to the right side. You can do this on your back. You're a one-legged pigeon. Go ahead and settle into your pose. Blankets and towels can also be put into this space under the right hip and thigh if there is a lot of space here. Breathe. Melt. If you can, support your head. Close your eyes.
'Cause in this life you must find something to live for. 'Cause when the darkness comes a calling, you go back to where you were before. 'Cause this life feels as fragile as a dream, and nothing's ever really as it seems. As it seems. As it seems.
demise.
As it seems.
Where's your attention? You get to choose how you want to be in this moment. You are the creator. You are the decider.
Clock strikes upon the hour, and the sun begins to fade. Still enough time.
And we'll slowly begin to make our way up. Take your absolute time in returning to all fours, taking any releasing movements that you need. So even if that means you want to go to down dog, that's cool too. Anything you want to do here, release and open. And hopefully, because we did a long time on that one side, your right hip feels really different than your left hip. And you're noticing, wow, right?
Somebody.
Isn't that amazing?
Somebody.
All right. No rush. When you're ready, return into all fours, knees together. Catch up whenever you want to. Left leg lift. Just hold it there for a little moment. Notice if you're collapsing your shoulders. Push the shoulder blades apart. A little bit higher. Inhale, squeeze. Take the foot between the hands. 90 degree bend, both knees, cushion if you need to, arms up to sky, lift it up. Exhale, hips. You can really feel and connect the movement of your hips, yeah? Your inhale, that little tailbone, let out. Exhale, that little tuck. And one more, inhale, tailbone up. Exhale, tuck, hold. Breathe. Imagine that your butt, tailbone, hips all are going to move forward. If you need more, that lean back. Opening up this right quad, top of the thigh, all the way up into the front of the right hip. And sky, inhale, release it open. Exhale, hands down. Half split, walk the toes out forward. Any amount. When you get there, explore. Tongue at the bottom of your mouth. Take it forward, low lunge. Left hand comes inside of the foot. Foot walks to the edge of the mat. And we start to settle into our lizard on this part, or this side. You can stay high on the hand so it feels awesome. You can go down to one or two elbows. You can roll your hips around in any direction. It might even feel really good to roll into the side of the right hip in a little side body stretch. Little safety band there.
Feathers in the pages, monkeys in my heart.
Feel your belly move as
rattling
you
rattling their cages. Found a way to blow, another ghost to follow. Said it's only up to you. It's the hardest pill to swallow.
And then working your way back up onto your... Oh, no, wait, sorry, I forgot it. Crooked monkey, I almost forgot. Bend the back knee, reach back with the left hand for your foot. If you want to go there, hug it in.
live on what they sent you. And you know they're gonna use.
Relax your jaw.
Things you
lips
love
are closed.
Against you. One foot in the grave. One foot in the shower.
Now let your back leg release. You turn up to your
time to save.
Left arm comes to the outside of the foot. And you're going to walk the foot over to the other edge of the mat. And we're going to keep that foot, the shin, parallel to the front of the mat. So again, this is very tight for you. Walk the back knee in. You have that support. So we're trying to get that left knee all the way down. You might even have to walk in a little bit more. That's okay. And it might not come all the way down. That's okay. We're working towards this really big external hip rotation, right? The full one-legged pigeon variation. But keeping your shin parallel to the front of the mat, right? Parallel to the two straight lines. Start to walk that back leg up. Start to settle into the ground. I like to rock side to side just because it feels awesome. Maybe it's in your body to go ahead and just fold all the way down. Now remember, we'll go back to the other variation later. Right now, just focus on that front leg, not budging from its spot.
And you're never out of hand. Never out of pocket. I'm supersonic man.
Now you can find your adjustments. Walk the front foot forward or inward if you need it. You're going to feel a big release there if you had a lot of tightness. You can lean off into the left hip. You can support the left hip with props. Coming down as low as you can, right? You can even do this on your back again. Back position. Ankle over the thigh, with or without hands. Support the head if you're able to. Hands block floor. Close the eyes. Melt here. Keep your mind where your body is. Stay here.
Eagle in the dark. Feathers in the pages. Monkeys in my heart, rattling their cages. I could learn to play the game.
The deeper your sensations in the body, the deeper your breath becomes.
If I only had the brains, the money or the love.
Soften your shoulders. Soften your neck. Making your way with no rush back into all fours, or if you need down dog, go for it. Take your releasing movements, whatever they are that feels natural to you, good to you, and feel that difference. Feel that left side. Ooh. Alright, today I want to give you a balancing thread the needle, right? I want you to watch it first, because when you're in thread the needle, you can't see anything, right? So what was going to, because you don't have to take the balanced version if you don't want to. What will happen is we'll do an inhale and arm up, we'll thread through, just watch first. How you're going to progress into the balance, if you want to go for it, is this is my right arm. I'll direct you, but your left leg will extend up and out, not opening the hip, but closing the hip. You get a twist right there in your back. You can stay there, or the left arm extends up and out. You can even go over the head if you want to. But this is your rotational balance. Remember, you don't have to do it. It's a little bit fun, a little challenging, and just something kind of fun to play with today. So all fours, do the right arm. Inhale, right arm to lift. Exhale, sweep it through. Right, shoulder and head to the ground. But if you have a different variation you want to play with, go for it. And then you might extend your left leg straight out behind you in the air, keeping your hip down. I have a wall, so I can't do it in this direction as much. And if that balance there feels really good, you can bring your left arm up, open it up behind you or over the head. Breathe. Falling's okay. Could it be anybody? I want somebody to love. And gently reverse. Take your time. And return to cat and cows.
I'm certain it happens all the time. What do you see when you turn out the light?
So we'll take the other side as you're ready.
Can't tell you.
Left arm, inhale to lift.
Oh,
exhale to sweep through.
Help from my friends.
You're just enjoying your stretch here. You're taking any variation you love, or we play. And the right leg extends out behind us, keeping the hip down. Maybe the right arm up, open, or over the head. Big breath. You don't have to hold it the whole time either. You can do it for a little bit and then return to a different variation you like.
Somebody to love. Oh, I get by with a little help from my friends.
Slowly start to reverse.
I'll try.
Return to all fours and cats and cows, taking your time.
Oh, I get high with a little help from my friends. Yes, I get by with a little help from my friends.
Finding neutral spine, let's come on to our sit bones. And from there, coming forward at the front of the mat and finding your spinal rolls or going straight to knee circles if you want. Rolling yourself back and up. If you enjoy plow poses and shoulder stands, you can take that here. Or if the rolls are feeling really yummy, take about 5 or 6 more.
Make you smile.
When you're done, we all meet up in knee circles to massage out the low spine.
Is grow old with you. Get your medicine when your tummy aches. Build you a fire when the furnace breaks. It could be so nice growing old with you.
From here, bottoms of your feet onto the mat. You're going to butterfly your knees out, having the feet actually kind of far away from you. You're going to do a little bit of core. Inhale, arms reach up over the head. You're going to sit up on a big, quick exhale. Now you know your feet have to be pretty far away from you. Inhale up. Slowly we go down. Exhale, 4.
I could be the man.
3.
Grows old.
2, 1, inhale up, open, quick exhale, lift. Inhale, look up. Roll it back. Look down. 6, 5, 4, shoulders down. 3, 2, 1. Inhale, open. Last time, lift it up. Inhale, reach up. Look down, exhale, last one, 8. 7. 6. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, stretch it out. Bring your feet together and touching. Take the left knee into the chest, give it a hug. Nice good squeeze there. Tuck the left toes behind the right knee. Guide your leg over and across, knee toward the ground. Right hand can help keep it grounded. Left arm opens out, head to the left. You can even snow angel that left arm in any direction. Just kind of figure out where you feel the best stretch in that left inside arm and front of the shoulders we're looking for there. If you have a different twist variation you loved, oh, take it.
Come away with me.
The right hand can also help move the top hip over.
Come away.
You could press the right hand into the top of the left thigh and push the top of the thigh kind of out and away from you. Get a little traction.
And I want to walk with you on a cloudy day.
Inhale, return to center, realign as needed.
Where the yellow grass grows.
Legs out in front, big toes touch. Right knee in, give it a hug, big squeeze. By your toes.
Come away with me as we kiss on a mountain top. Come away with me.
Tuck toes. Twist over to the left. Head to the right if it's okay for your neck. Right arm. Where does the right arm feel the best stretch? For my body, it's right there today. And even as that stretch opens, I have to search deeper in a little moment. Left hand can help to guide the hip or press very top of the thigh out and away from you. And slowly return. Taking any last position that you feel your body needs. I always love a knee to chest release. As you're ready, opening up into your last pose, your Shavasana. Your arms coming about 45 degrees from the body. Legs are nice and opening, and use all that space you have. Head resting in the very center of the back of the head. Remove anything in the way. Shoulder blades tuck slightly. Maybe you have something to cover your eyes with, enjoying that darkness. Take a moment to open your mouth as big as you can, wiggle your jaw, and then let your jaw relax, your tongue floating in the mouth. Continue this practice, keeping our minds where our bodies are. Our breath becoming the bridge that joins the body and the mind together. inside of you. In this immediate awareness, there is no need for anger or worry. We open ourselves to peace. Understanding. We keeping your eyes open. Begin to move your breath alone. Let movement return. Fingers and toes. listening. Gentle rock of your head side to side. If you'd like, take a stretch as if you just woke up. Perhaps a yawn, a wiggle of the tongue. Walking the feet into the sit bones, you can hug the knees if it feels right. Rolling over to either side of your body. The head on your arm or on the hands. We slowly make our way up to any comfortable sitting position. Refreshed, restored. As you move about the rest of the day into the week, let your actions, your words, and your intentions come from a place of love, of awareness, of peace and calm, and unity. As we inhale, reach the arms up to the sky, touch the palms, stretch tall. Exhale, we bring the palms together to the heart. And from our refreshed, open, and loving hearts, we say, Namaste.